Should be March the next 2003 Subcommittee meeting for today. I'm Councillor Harry Smith, I'll chair this meeting today. On my right is Councillor Holmby, and on my left is Councillor Salter. You've got your name there, John. And I'll go around and ask the people at the table to introduce themselves.
McKenna Brown, senior citizen, and the advisor to the
I'm also on the licensing manager.
This is the licensing officer.
Andrew Bushell, licensing operations manager.
I'm Simon Barrigan, and I'm the licensing sergeant for Merseyside Police in the Wirral area.
I'm Brian Kenny, public councillor for Birmingham and Tranmere Ward.
Andrew Pritchard, representative of the division.
Pritchard.
Yes.
Now, just remind everybody that this is quite a formal procedure, and we have a set of procedure that we adhere to. So I'll be asking certain questions of people at the table. The people who are in the audience should not speak or make any contribution whatsoever, okay? Because if you do, and they will close the meeting down and adjourn the meeting and clear the room, okay? So people in the audience, please do not say anything. People around the table or your representative and Councillor Kenny will speak on your behalf, okay? Thank you very much. Sergeant Barrigan will explain just what the multicoloured dots represent on this chart when it comes to your tackle. Is that okay?
Yes.
Would that be acceptable then, okay? Okay.
Sorry, Chair, can I ask you, is it possible to have a copy of that?
I thought you'd got one, haven't
I? Apologies, I didn't have a copy of it. I can share this one with us.
Okay, right.
Okay, yeah, okay.
Okay, is there any party at the table has requested permission to call another person to the hearing? No? Okay, thank you. Is there any other further information or documents in form or otherwise that you wish to present? No? Thank you. Do you wish to ask questions of each other, Mr. Jordan?
Yes.
And yourself?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, the formal procedure is that I will now proceed to hear and determine the application. Sorry, we will now proceed to hear and determine the application with reference to the Council's Statement of Licensing Policy, the statutory guidance issued under Section 182 of the Licensing Act 2003, and the four licensing objectives, which are prevention of crime and disorder, public safety, prevention of public nuisance, protection of children from harm. Mark, would you outline the facts of the case, please?
Yes, thank you, Chair. The purpose of the hearing this afternoon is to consider an application for the grant of the premises licence for a premises located at number 43 Woodchurch Road, Birkenhead. The application is for the grant of a premises licence to allow the sale of alcohol 7 days a week, 6 a.m. until 11 p.m, with the hours open to the public from 6 a.m. until 11 p.m. In respect of the application, there have been representations from local residents, from ward councillors, from the licensing authority, and from their society police. And those people are here this afternoon to speak to you in respect of the representations that have been made.
you speak in support of the application?
So, first of all, start with some issues that have been suggested by licensing authorities and by police. Yes, they are requested over 100 hours to 2300 hours to move into some regional bus flexibility retail. The green suggested on the representation, it says suggested conditions, this is a police representation last page, it says suggested conditions that could be added to the license to remedy the representation. Or other suggestions you would like the license to take into account the annual loan. Sale of alcohol to drinks at 8 a.m, so that would be agreed. Training for all staff members, unload sales, process sales, and selling alcohol to intoxicated persons. Recorded in Monday the 6 month group, that can be agreed. Copies of the training records to be made available to responsible authorities on the request, that can be agreed. A beer or cider is sold in the name of the rate of 6.5%, that can be agreed. And no single pants is sold, that can be agreed. And the CCTV as per the rules by the council's meeting of specification, that can be agreed. And suggested conditions by the licensing authority, the DPS and subcommittee to designate registered supervisors, number one, to agree. Number two, that is all members of staff, board of councils, and subcommittee will be responsible for the rehabbing. We would say all members of staff involved in sale of alcohol, so we put that slightly. Because obviously the staff will join the premises if the license is granted, they might not hold the responsible alcohol board. They could be prevented from selling alcohol to their town alcohol board. But they might be involved in shelfing or proceedings beforehand. All staff must receive regular training, including licensing objectives, licensing hours, agents and sales. There must be a written record of effective all training required. This training should be conducted with all staff in 6 months at the minimum. And I think that's the same as the physical degree, which is free. And all staff must be trained on the use of CCTV system to access footage and transferring footage. I think that could be rephrased as one member of staff on duty at all times to train on the use of CCTV system to access. Slightly working back, one member of staff on duty at all times, not all staff, security would be a number of staff around 62 buildings. It's a summary we have to provide a copy. They have asked for 10 to 2200 hours as a suggested addition.
Usual
time.
Usual
seems to be the entire class is 8 hours. So those conditions can be agreed.
Anyone?
It's okay. Mr. Ezraza can be experienced operator in the appears to be one issue for one of those premises of sale of hours, which was a member of the staff, and they've been fully told in circumstances. I'm not sure that he was approached about the problem before it was found by one of the staff, so I doubt that by somebody. So he regrets that mistake and has really changed status of the current circumstances that we have had. The area where this premises is not in the proposed CIZ, so under the consultation, so that's where we are on that. Obviously, the training cover for the areas that's suggested in the 50% rules, ASB rules, whether that's actually.
You can ask that question yourself after, because you know, okay.
We're not sure whether these are alcohol rates or not, we don't seem to be in fact, this is alcohol related. So, the applicant has experience in that premises, and there's one member staff who sold about 1,000, who's been known for a lot of hours.
So I thought it was here. that I'm not a son of it. And the record is 6 months, therefore my history, my record is a teaching evidence of 6 month record there. If you don't get that for now, you don't want to expect it. 6 month record is a different state of calendar. Every so.
Andy, these are questions.
Yes.
Comments, okay,
yes.
So you're asking questions.
Yeah, I've no questions, I'll cover some parts of my presentation.
Mr. McCandle, do you own the lease for 43 Woodchurch Road?
Yeah, it's still processing now.
So the answer is no?
Processing now, yes.
So the answer is no?
Yeah, not properly that.
So you're asking the committee to grant a license to a premises that you don't have a legal entitlement to? You're asking the committee to grant a license to a premises that you do not own the lease for?
But then it's the landlord is saying to me, landlord is saying to me, or it's something, I have to do more of it, never done. You have to lose this process as a plan today. Then I thought, I can tell you something that is probably tomorrow. Then I'm going to take the last thing. And you take your money also with £5,000. All of the stuff, in 3 days also myself, I take it like this, it's dollar. And my post of this all last things. Before this, all the equipment, you have to capture and it's a 7% of that is zero. It is the same. It's a heavy capture. And it's the another one is in that piece of all house I do like this and this is a subject house also before companies and these I get the last things. Then I get the last thing I can get the least that is so support this possible. That's why I need to pay the money.
Mr. McAndu, is there a covenant on 43 Woodchurch Road preventing it from becoming an off license?
There is. I'm not sure to understand. Are you able to explain that in any further detail?
That's the only thing I've been told that the insurance wants to cover that.
But there is a covenant on that premises that prevents it from putting it on
and all the landlord equipment are forced to 28 is not sealed to landlord and then also equipment that
I know
the
questions,
Chair.
Okay.
Councillor Kenny, you go first before Mr. Pitcher?
Yeah, okay, Chair. Sure.
Questions, Brian, okay?
Just questions.
Questions at the moment?
I've got no questions at this stage.
Okay. You'll make your representation later.
Yeah, okay.
Mr. Pritchard, any questions to
only the applicant? With regards to suggested sales on Peter Cobham 1, because you said that seems to be a going time that area.
But what, sir?
You suggested the sale of alcohol start at Peter Cobham 1, because it seems to be a going time for the area. When there's two shops within 500 yards, with license and times from 9 o'clock and 10 o'clock respectively.
Oh, okay.
I'm just wondering where you're getting the information from.
The nearly 8 to 11 also less have license. 8 to 11 also also it's good to last time. 8 to 11 also they get the license open. Yeah. 8 to 11 the license they get the cops license.
But one
8 to 11, I already put that last in the paper, yeah. 8 to 11. Normally, it's not a last in 8 to 11.
Can I just say that when you submit an application before they have to accept the independent application, that would be the conditions in need to go to another premises. Well, not necessarily mean that that has to apply to this premises. Okay. I mean, there are other premises, and if you move the representation from the license authority, something that you can voluntarily agree or decide that that's something you want to do politically. It doesn't mean that because other parents are being told that that's a part of the process.
Any other questions, Mr. Chair? No questions, okay.
Yeah, you just come with it then. I want to clarify that this was not your account for now. It is the norm. We are not doing the norm. We're doing one premises only for six premises.
Question.
And I'll just make a statement back that it's not the norm. And another way you're getting it, because we've just been told now at different times, so please, it isn't the norm.
Okay.
And I've had those here for quite a long time. It is not the norm.
Any questions?
Yeah,
no.
It's just that it was a time that takes a lot of the license to see that.
It's not just things at all.
As you say, it's just.
Sorry.
Any questions? Do you have a shop plan? Shop plan?
Shop plan.
Shop plan.
Proposed shop plan.
Show on this plan where the alcohol will be stored if the application is granted. It would help if you had your own plan away.
No, I think I did that. I think it was pretty bad.
Jordan, can you address those, please?
Yeah, sorry.
Okay.
Obviously, we have assessed the particular areas. We assessed the maximum percentage of the entire area to alcohol.
So you could have stacks of beer outside the door?
Well, we could have the door.
Well, I think that's what
I'm not asking. 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 Produce is going to be selling at the frequency that is going to be alcohol.
Mr. Jordan, you're not speaking to us.
Sorry.
You know, please speak to us, okay?
So I also ask him, when the gentleman's speaking also, do you not over speak? Because you keep over speaking and I can't understand what he's saying. I told you, if you just allow him to speak, please. Thank you.
Sorry.
No, it's not you, Mr. Jordan, over speaking.
On that theme, what else will the shop sell if the alcohol license is granted? What else will be sold at the premises? What other goods will be sold at the premises? Will you sell newspapers?
No, newspaper is also not there. Newspaper, one of the store boards, or also the.
Yeah.
No, of course, one of the store. You said that newspaper also in a very good special also.
Tin goods.
Tin bar.
Tinned.
What is it? I don't know. Sorry.
Cans. Cans. Spaghetti.
Spaghetti. Yeah, everything. Didn't have everything. Didn't have everything. Only this got normally everything also. Pepper. Even pepper because I don't pour some pepper there and also there.
Okay.
Everything.
Any questions?
Only this
got. I've never heard of the shops.
I don't have so.
Haven't?
I haven't. How much do you offer?
No, you have a member of other shops, four or five.
I thought five so far.
Right. And in relation to this premises, how many people are you looking to employ or have employed there? And
Three people. Each man has each of the time, or all of the time.
And are you in the premises, or do you just go from one to another, or what?
No, from the board supposed to be last night, supposed to be last night. Everyone for all classes. Everyone for half classes, all classes, supposed to be.
So you're going to get everybody who's with a personal license?
Personal, everyone with a personal license.
Will you work in that shop?
Yeah. Normally also, I did. Everyone got an ID similar. Of course, I did. I paid a man also, I did last night. Their staff also,
every
so.
Right, so you have each member of staff
give
personal license?
Each member of the
personal staff. So, in relation to your application, you put yourself down as the proposed designated premises supervisor.
Huh?
You put yourself down as the proposed designated DPS?
Yeah, DPS. I did this. I might have to do DPS.
Yes. So are you designated? Are you reading that?
Yes, I got the model supposed to.
So you designated premise supervisor for this premises?
Yes.
Are you designated premise supervisor for any other premises?
No. Only my shop.
Each shop?
A shop is a developer supervisor. I can't handle that shop as an exam supervisor.
Is it Mr. Martin to do a DPS for all these other shops?
not working then? Are they just people who would require the family members or
something? This shop is working in there.
Right. So if it's open, it's going to be
not a part
of the company. So you're going to be an employee,
yes.
In DPS.
DPS and also
to come to the